to our 2016 Best Practices Showcase, celebrating technology innovation for Hispanic success in higher education. My name is Yalitza Castro, and I will be in charge of introducing the speakers for this breakout session. This session is being recorded. The presenters will let you know whether you will be able to address your questions at any time during the presentation or after the presentation has finished. This presentation will be in English, right?
It could be by
English. It could be by however, simultaneous translation services in Spanish will be on channel 4 for you to listen. Additional headphones are available at the exhibitors area, downstairs on the registration area. We will appreciate that you change your mobile phone to bright vibration or silent mode in order to have your full attention to this session. Finally, I will distribute the evaluation form, so I will kindly request to make sure to complete it before the session and hand it over to me before you leave this room. Well, now we are ready to start. The presenters for this section are Mr. Francisco García, Anthony Salinas, and Dr. Ramiro de la Rosa, all of them from the University of Texas, Rio Grande Valley. Well, they're recently named University of Texas, Rio Grande Valley. So, go ahead.
Thank you. Right?
Okay, there's no need.
Alright. Well, thank you. Thank you for being here. Yeah, my doctor much, right? Hope you don't fall asleep. Chicken was good. Gamification, that's what we're going to be talking about today, and how gamification and of course, quality in online courses are being helped in the university. And meeting its goals of having online education available. Before we start with the session, well, those are the session topics for today. So we're going to talk about the definitions, the framework of gamification. And I say definitions because there might be more than one definition on that. Then we have the quality assurance. We heard from the keynote speaker about quality is important nowadays in online. Well, not only on online, but in education in general. And then how gamification is playing a key role at UTRGV. We're gonna show some results, of course, what's next in a project. And at the end, we're gonna have some questions and possible answers. So what's up?
Does it work?
But before we go into the details of gamification, just want to give you a little bit of who we are. Yalitza mentioned it's the new university, so we're the newest component of UT system. We opened the doors in Amsterdam first as the first class of 2015. Officially, the university was founded in September the 1st, so we are 4.5 months old, right? So where are we? Where are we located? We're in the southernmost part of Texas. You see Texas here. It's all the way to the bottom, by the border.
Under the screen.
At the bottom and by the sea, right?
Wow.
Now we are a distributed unified campus. This code is coming from our provost, who's right here. And we offer more than around 120 programs, some programs over there, 64 undergraduates, 49 masters, 4 doctors, doctoral programs, and 2 currently doctorals with other universities. Student population, we start, when we opened our doors, there were about 28,000 plus students, and 25,000 of them are Hispanic, so we're 90%+ of Hispanic. And I would make sure that this quote was right. So we are the second largest Hispanic serving institution in the nation. Online learning. There is this center for online learning, which is happening to be that I'm the director of. So we got a mission that it's somehow aligns with the university mission on offering courses or student access to courses. We currently have two centers. Since we're a distributed campus, we got centers in the main campuses in Edinburgh, Texas, and Brownsville, Texas. And this is what we call the Wall of Fame. These are the programs that we offer online. We vary from master's programs, graduate certificates. We even have accelerated programs. There was a presentation about accelerated courses this morning. So we also offer those courses. Those are about 6-7 weeks courses. So we actually get two semesters in one, or two sessions, two modules in one semester. And we also have some partially online.
Sorry. But
yeah. And those partially online, that means that since we don't have all the core courses online, so we have to declare those as a partially instead of having it fully online. But again, the core of the courses, the electives and everything, it's online. This is some of the online statistics this fall semester. 445 online sections, 268 faculty teaching online, which half of this, about 50% of these students coming to faculty, they're already certified by Quality Matters. So quality is also a key in our department. 9,000, close to 10,000 students taking at least one online courses. And then, so that makes 35% of the students, like I said, taking at least one online course. So with that said, now I'm going to pass it to Anthony, who's one of the experts on gamification.
You call me a guru, but it's still in infancy, so, and there's just so much to learn. And that's why I'm going to cover what we've learned. And as an instructional designer, we were, as we see in the picture, how we started, we wanted to get an Oculus. Has anybody heard of the Oculus? It's the new virtual reality headset. For simulations. We heard about it, we got excited, and we wanted to pursue it. But our director at the time asked us, and currently our director now asked us, well, before that happens, I mean, before we can even grant you such a tool, what are you going to use it for, how are you going to get started? And that's where this whole gamification took, just like, it hit the wheels on the rails, and we just kind of went at it. And there's a lot to go around. So I'm just cover some of the game thinking. Before I even started doing or introducing gamification to any or discussing it with any faculty, we wanted to make sure we were up to date with what was out there. I personally took several certification courses online through Coursera, edX, MIT, just so I can understand game design, game theory, and at the same time how or what this applies to, especially in the private sector, which is it's used heavily. Right here are some two books or definitions of gamification by two experts, Carl Kapp and Yukai Zhao. But what they come down to is gamification is application of game design in a non-game environment. And we were all part of it this lunch when we had this non-game environment of a raffle at this conference. The behavior is to for have you to register for their items, but to incentivize you, they ask you to put your names in a raffle and get the $100. So that's the whole idea of gamification, adding a game element into a non-game environment. So why, again, why gamification, why even start with this? We want to look at how it can improve motivation, engagement, retention. Can this possibly stimulate productivity and create inquiry, create positive change in behavior, which again, we can relate that this is more like it. So, and knowledge acquisition in a fun way. Can you change the next one? Again, why does it matter? Learners recall 10% of what they read, 20% of what they hear, 30% of what they hear and read, 50% of what they observe, and most, 90% if they do it themselves, even in the simulation. And then that simulation is what's key. That's what we want, the VR, the Oculus Rift. But I'll talk about that later on. Next slide. And then 80% of learners say that their productivity would increase if their university has more of a game-like feel. So that's what we're trying to strive for. So I want to cover some misconceptions. While reading all the content out there, and there's a lot of content, you'll hear gamification being discussed by actual game designers and gamification by private sector individuals that use it for years, and then gamification from an education or academic standpoint. And everybody has different definitions, different sayings, and how things apply in different scenarios. So it's a jumble. It really is. But it's not to say it's not too complicated to understand or kind of condense into something that we can all utilize in our field of study. First one, gamification and game-based learning are the same. That's a misconception. Right off the bat, what we made. We wanted to utilize the Oculus Rift to develop something with gamification, but game-based learning is the development of a game for an educational purpose. So do anybody remember back in the day, Math Chompers, Oregon Trail? Basically those reading, what, Reader Rabbit? Those are learning games. What's that new one that just came out, the Mouse 1-2-3? Again, it's a standalone game where education is being taken place. Another example can be Duolingo, the app, utilizing the game for educational purposes. Gamification, as I just kindly, quickly pointed out, is utilizing game design in a non-gaming environment. So, although the rational today didn't seem like wasn't in a game board, we utilize game thinking to incentivize individuals to change their behavior to sign up for certain things. That's gamification. Gamification is simply points, badges, leaderboards. This one comes out in a lot of papers. Individuals utilize points, badges, leaderboards and call it gamification. Although in some cases it is, and I will talk about it later, it shouldn't just be pointed out in this direction. There's so much out there, there's just so much more elements of game design that don't focus just on what the LMS is providing you or what technologies are out there. Expand on it a little bit more. So don't just point towards points, badges, and leaderboards. It's a little too narrow. Expand, there's again, so much more out there. Gamification is just a buzzword. but it's been utilized for some time. Green stamps, does anybody remember green stamps? Back in the day, they utilized green stamps and it's a loyalty program. Again, most of us have known or used loyalty programs in stores. But green stamps was utilized back in the day. You go to their brick and mortar store, you purchase items, you get stamps. The more stamps you collect, you put it in a book. The catalog comes in, and you can purchase stuff from the catalog based on the green stamps. So it's incentivizing you to shop at their stores only, be a loyal customer, and come back and use those stamps to purchase gifts. If you fill out the whole catalog, you're given an extra gift, not extra gift, but more premium gift because they call you the more loyal customer. So, although in our area of study, it's a buzzword, it's been utilized heavily already in the past to change the behavior of customers, but we want to change the behavior of our customers, which are our learners. And gamification is not a cure-all. That's another thing to remember. If there's an issue with the course, if there's an issue with, or you feel that your students aren't being engaged, aren't really paying attention to class, maybe our attendance is too low, gamification might not be the solution. You might have to actually step back and reflect on yourself, maybe your teaching's off, maybe your course design's incorrect. So before, and we suggest this, before you even consider gamification, reflect on what you've already done in the past. Go to your surveys or what you've done before. And don't put makeup on a pig, basically. You don't want to muddle anything further. And types of gamification. There's two types, structural gamification. And I remember I mentioned not to always point towards points and badges and leaderboards, but there's a reason why I'm putting this in the next one. Khan's Academy. Anybody visit Khan's Academy? It's a great resource. I recommend you utilize it. Great way they kind of set it up. But what they do is they have a structural gamification. Structural gamification is the structuring of content in a method that allows students to progress in a structure that's also scaffolded to kind of go progress at a certain difficulty level. So they start off at level one, they move to level two, and then they progress to level three. So the actual content isn't changed, it's packaged. So if level one is learning how to add, level two then goes into multiplication. You're not gonna, those adding and multiplication is gonna be concrete. The method of adding and subtracting and what have you is gonna be concrete. The structural part is how the student kind of moves through the environment or the content. Let me go to the next one. So Khan Academy has points, they have leaderboards and badges, basically showcasing the student the progression through the content, how basically what they achieved, are they a star learner, etc. Again, I just started messing with this so I can get examples. Content gamification, if you go to the next one to show the image, is the actual manipulation of the content itself. So the story is added. So in this case, I wanted to showcase the zombie run because that's a good example of content gamification. The non-game environment, I guess you could say, is the act of running, going out to do regular jogging. But introducing the app, Zombie Run, you're introduced to an unfolding world, immersive world, where you're a survivor, you're coming up out of the zombie apocalypse, and it starts off with a helicopter crash, and you have to go look for supplies to go to a base. And as you walk, and when you have the app on, you hear zombies approach you as you slow down your pace. So the content is actually fits the situation, I guess. Basically, these are just images from the permit. This is the one I wanted to show. That it's a comic made by the people on the internet that are fans of Zombie Run. Basically, they showcase the jogger crying and two individuals saying, "Why is she crying?" Well, it's because she's playing Zombie Run. She's so immersed into it. And again, it was just a regular act of running. But the Zombie Run incentivizes you to it just incentivizes you to run and get pursuit of further. Gaming elements. This one's a huge, you can get misconceptions here. You'll hear gaming elements and see or read about every one of these here. I personally enjoy kind of chunking in this way, components, mechanics, and dynamics. Gaming elements that you can consider into a course. Quests, you can have quests within the class or set it up in that method. So within module one, the first quest is introduce yourself to your clan, which is your group. And then I'm saying clan, so I'm using that story also, which I didn't add here, but it's also a mechanic. You can also incorporate challenges, competition, feedback, resource acquisition. Can you, if y'all remember or have seen the Clash of Clans, if you've seen Clash of Clans, you can pick up coins, you can pick up mana for magic potions and whatnot. But what you want to do is use a combination of these. And again, this is why I mentioned, don't just focus on points, badge, leaderboards. You can pick and choose from one of these to build a better gamified environment in your course. And depending on what technologies you have at your, that you can utilize in the class, I know we're trying to figure out how to properly use leaderboards in a classroom without interfering with FERPA. But again, that's just something we're trying to work on. And again, like I said, there's more to gamification than just adding elements. You want to use the combination to push into the class.
So on motivation, so why are we doing this? Why are we talking about gamification? Why are we interested in it? Why are researchers interested in it? Well, it comes down to motivation. As you mentioned, the runner is being motivated by the zombies trying to catch you. You're motivated by a $100 gift card because to be there through the lunch to network.